welcome to another exciting edition of the big interview here at the MG Grand Hotel in Accra. This is Football Made in Ghana TV for you. With me today is one of the big coaches in Ghana, arguably the biggest coach in Ghana as of now. The headlines are on him, the media are at his doorstep. Every attention has been shifted to his direction. With me today is the head coach of Kumasi Asante Kotoko, CK Akonnor. Good morning, coach.
Good morning.
I believe you're fine.
Fine.
How has it been with Asante Kotoko?
It's been a long journey. Even though it's short period of time, it's been a journey, ups and downs, you know. But determination and the fear of God has taken us very, very far.
You seem to be God-fearing. Every time you talk about God,
you always need to give Him the glory, you know. Because if He had me in Him, we would not be sitting here. You know? Get the sun free of charge without charging air. And sometimes we take certain things for granted.
You have a very enviable record. You've coached all the biggest clubs in the country. You coach Accra House of Folk, you coach Asante Gold, you coached Dreams FC, and now you are with Kumasi Asante Kotoko. How has the experiences been when you compare?
Well, it's been different. You know? The time when I started with Lemon Wise cannot be compared to this time around. But I was eager to learn. I was obedient to the job itself. And I didn't take my ego as a player who have the chance to captain Wolfsburg and
the Black Stars
ahead of me, you know. I need to start from zero. You know, if I was maybe a good player or whatever, that should not lead me. And humbly, I started learning, and gradually, I was improving. And if I have to look back, I would say it's not over, but I've done well.
You seem to have a relationship with traditional clubs. You played for Akonnor United, which was a traditional club. You coached 11 Wise, a traditional club. Accra House of Folk, traditional club. And you are now with Kumasi Asante Kotoko, also a traditional club. What is it like that makes you close to a lot of traditional clubs?
That is where the challenge is, you know. And I look for challenges. Things that probably one will see is at a very, very difficult thing. And because I want to do this to the highest level, if I really want to be a good coach, then I must go through this difficult time. Sometimes you go there, you'll be successful, but you struggle.
Yeah.
You know, it's demanded that every time, every now and then, the results are coming. And of course, you have fans who are passionate about the team. They want to see the team win. And it brings a lot of pressure on you, you know. And so, for instance, when I went to Ashgold, there was no way human, you know,
yes.
It
wasn't that reasonable because at the time you were going, the club was fighting relegation, but you accepted the challenge.
Yeah. And I remember that my family, Dreams FC, Kate was, are you crazy? You know? But like I said, if you really want to do this to the highest level, you must go through challenges. Sometimes some of the, you risk, I have risk. I risk in this because I could easily fail.
Yeah.
You know, and it will be on my
CV.
CV that I went there and I didn't. And that's when God comes in.
Yeah.
You know, because I wouldn't be able to do it if it's, I'm not favored in that sense.
Mm.
I believe so much in that favor. The favor will take you very far. And that's how it's been. The traditional clubs, difficult moments, it's a challenge. And once you go through, it's another hurdle. You know. It gives you more experience, you understand the level, how you have to deal with certain things, and it goes on.
You've coached, you started with 11 Wise, you came to Hearts of Oak, Dreams FC, Ashgold, and now Asante Kotoko. Which of these clubs would you say has offered you the biggest challenge or the most difficult moment in your coaching career?
Of course, it's Asante Kotoko. Hearts of Oak, I think, impatient, you know, I can understand it. Impatient, pressure, and board, Toby had to, you know. But if they were patient, probably maybe I would have changed things. As good, I put myself there in that risk. But Kotoko, I went to Kotoko without knowing that we're going to be part of it.
In this competition.
In this competition. And also, there was nothing going on, you know. So I have started preparing for probably in 6 months' time or 7 months' time that we'll have a serious competition. Then all of a sudden,
the competition came.
And so quickly, it was a big challenge, first of all, because even the players we got were not fit, you know, and how to organize it within, I think, within a month. You know. What helped us most for us to get here was when we had that walkover.
Yes, yes, over the Cameroonian club, the Edding Sports.
Yeah, because I think around that time we were not ready.
What is your greatest memory at Dreams FC? Because it is a club that you qualified into the Ghana Premier League. You took them from the Division 1 and then you brought them back into the Ghana Premier League. What is your greatest memory with the club? And what would you say is something that you learned from Dreams FC?
Well, I learned a lot. On personal relationship, I learned a lot from, as a football perspective. And then also the organization, the way they are organized, you know. Kate was able to get everybody together. And that was the second time that a team of that nature, you know, a team board, we meet, including the, and then we plan.
Okay.
I've had that experience with Asafo, but we couldn't compare it.
Okay.
Asafo was more of, that's what happened, what went wrong, dreams, what can we do? And everybody was sharing ideas, you know. Sometimes we disagree, agree, and then we talk about the game. And so, yes, I learned a lot from there. And then also, one of the moments that I will never forget, when we were asked to go down to
Division 1,
and we all sat down, everybody came out with his view, some disagree, some said, and I just told them, we should go, and I'm going to be here, I'm not going to go anywhere, you know, because it was such a family, you know,
yeah, sure.
And the way things were going was, and I loved it. They can get on your nerves,
you sure, know,
but it's good. It's a positive one. So I grew from that in terms of, you know, we are talking, discussing, disagreeing, but agreeing, you know, because we had a target.
Sure.
Purpose. It was purposeful, you know, meaningful meetings most of the time. And sometimes you can get hot, or you can get somebody else can get hot. It's not necessarily me. But of course,
yeah.
Most of the time, and so it worked in that manner, and I loved the way the organization was made and everything. So I have a lot of positive.
Now let's zoom in on Asante Kotoko. Last weekend, you drew 1-1 with Al Hilal in Kumasi. Ahead of the game, you suffered a lot of injuries. Gani was not in the Maxwell Bakon did not play. Jemfi was doubtful for the game. And a couple of others. Would you say the injuries affected your play, and that is how come you got a 1-1 stalemate?
Well, it really affected. You forgot about Sienu.
Sure.
You
know?
Sienu absence was felt, you know, because of he was a very key link between defense and attack, you know? And he did it. At the beginning, we struggled, but we pushed him so well that he fit in quickly. And then all of a sudden he got injured. Then Baku was also necessary when we have possession and all that, and to go attack, also got injured. It also affected us. And then Jemfi came in.
Daniel.
So obviously the structures had been
crumbled.
Yeah. And so we had to think deep, who can fit in, you know, and we started encouraging them. But of course, our style of play changed. Changed a bit, and sometimes it's necessary to have good bench. You know, those who came in have done very well. Umar has really fit in very well. I'm very happy with him. He's intelligent.
You know?
And some have struggled. You know, so we are managing the situation, and it's difficult. But here we are now. We don't have any complaint. We don't want to focus on that. But what can we do to improve the situation? And that is what we're doing. And then also, probably luck was not on our side on last Sunday's one. Because we struggled in certain areas. We didn't play very well.
You created decent chances and missed them.
Yeah, missed them. And then, also, of course, fatigue is also another major factor. Mm.
Personally, I know Habib Mohamed has been one of the greatest holding midfielders in the country. You work with him at Ashgold, and there are those who are arguing that, looking at his structure and how good he is defensively, it will be good to offer him the platform, possibly playing against Zesco United.
Well, we have in mind, but don't forget, he joined us late. Mm. So whatever we've done, he wasn't there.
Sure.
It's going to take him some time. You know, there's a difference between he knows me and he knows what I do. But he got to know the team. He has to breathe them, where they run and all that. And this is a moment where the timing is not good. But of course, he's shown good sign in the matches that he's played. Mm. And it's possible he will start on Sunday, coming Sunday. Mm.
Sonia Yakuba will not be playing. He's serving a suspension. How will it affect your team? Because he has been the lead attacker all this while. His absence.
It's a fact that he's very instrumental in the way we approach the game, the way we go forward. Mm. But those who have the chance now have to take him with it. We have three strikers now, and whoever will be given a chance, or four, should be able to play to fit in. And then if you're not able to, then it's clear that
you don't fit
in the style of play, or you know, and they've all been here for a while, and as you know, so this is an opportunity for the Reds who have not been playing to take it.
You now have the Ivorian striker Tigay, you have Fatau, Frederick Boateng, and then Obed Owusu. Who is likely to lead the attack on Sunday? But will this be a very good platform for Tigay to also have his first shot in the team?
Yeah, but Tigay is struggling with his fitness level. I'm not too happy with it. I realize he sat home for quite a long time, which is very poor for a player. He wants to play active football. And so he's struggling with his fitness, but he's in the plan. We are looking forward to him a chance to play. Mm.
Zesco United have conceded 6 goals in their last 2 games. They conceded 3 against Al Hilal, and they conceded 3 against Nkana. What does it tell you as a coach who is now going into that territory to play them?
Well, it tells you they have weakness, but it also tells you that they want to now check, hey, what is wrong? You know, and once they check and check well, and you the next opponent, you struggle. And so it gives us a belief that we can, if we do things right, we can score. At the same time, the fear of them now rectifying their mistakes and not making a necessary mistake. You know, compared to us, we were conceding goals. And then before the Ghana home match, we were determined. Can have that sense of judgment, and we did it very well. And for them, even though they've lost, they're not going to qualify. What is left is pride, and sometimes when you have that, can help you to play well. But we have in mind, we know we don't have any opportunity than to win. You know, we don't have any excuse. We have to win for us to be able to stay in this competition. We have to. If we don't win, we are out. That is a fact.
If you just tuned in, with me here is the head coach of Kumasi, Asante Kotoko, former Black Stars skipper and former skipper for Bundesliga side VfL Wolfsburg. This is a coach who in the last 27 years is the best coach for Kumasi, Asante Kotoko in terms of statistics. He's the fourth coach in 15 years to have been able to qualify Asante Kotoko to the group stage of the CAF club competitions. And as we are talking now, he will be the first coach to qualify the club in 16 years to the quarterfinals of the competition. CK, if you are able to achieve this particular feat, to be the first coach in 16 years to qualify Kotoko to the quarterfinals of the CAF club competition, that is either the Confederation Cup or the Champions League, how will it sound for you?
Well, I've not thought of that. And in fact, this is for you guys. I'm just working, you know, and I don't look at history, what can be done. I look at it as a job, what can be done, you know, to complete it. And since we drew, it looks like we've lost because we could have killed it.
Mm.
But sometimes, bittersweet, sometimes the last minute, you know, and I'm very, very hopeful that we can win in Zesco. Very, very hopeful. And once we are determined, dedicated to the things we want to do, and we go and do it well, nothing should stop us. Of course, we must have the belief. We have the belief. I personally have the belief. I don't know about my boys.
Yeah.
And so we will try as much as we can. But I don't know. I know I have a feeling we will do it. But it's all in the hands of God. I don't know what the future is.
This is a coach that I personally believe that even if Asante Kotoko are unable to qualify to the quarterfinal stage of the competition, spending more time with the club will enhance their chances of being a dominant force, not only in Ghana, but in Africa. Finally, coach, you are taking off. You get to Zambia. You prepare for Zesco United. How is the approach going to be?
Approach in terms of how we will play?
Yes.
That again. But we are determined. We have a little change of style of play a bit, and to make sure that we are able to mount pressure and not necessarily pressing high. We are well organized and try to push them and force them to make the necessary mistakes.
Coach, we are very much grateful for your time. Thank you very much, and we wish you all the best of luck when you go to Zambia.
Thank you.